Going to 2:23:13, Parable 14, Confessions of Reverend Green at 14.
Ray.
Hey, good morning. Long time listener, first time caller.
Yeah.
First time caller today.
Hey, do we talk enough sports for you, Ray?
Hey, always. You know,
Jeremy says we don't.
I get the scores wrong before I go to bed when I'm watching the score, and like that night Iowa State was blowing somebody out in Kansas, and then they lost. You know, I woke up the next day, yeah. Like they lost. They called in team, they're like it's number
14.
But hey, breaking up the.
Now,
days ago, I know
he's
doing
the Outlaws of Iowa.
Listen to the show. He's making ghetto garlic bread. Break that down for me.
Ghetto garlic bread is just taking a regular loaf of wheat sandwich bread, buttering both sides, and then sprinkling garlic salt on it and stick it in the oven. That's it.
Just some Wonder Bread, just in white sliced bread. Or you can use buns.
I can't.
I have buns for that too.
I can't do that. You could. I can't do the Wonder Bread. There's something that freaks me out about bread that's not going to mold.
What about a ghetto mac and cheese? You ever had that?
What's ghetto mac and cheese?
Well, that's when you either don't have butter or you don't have milk.
Ooh, that's not good, Ray.
You know, when that's all you got on the shelf, you know.
That's all you've got.
That's all you got. You know, so thanks for bringing the show and, Ben Hart got me blocked on emails. He cut me off on email.
Are you serious?
Yeah, years ago. Yeah. You guys are great, you know.
How do you know you're blocked? Does it come back?
He emailed me personally and said, take me off your list. Don't email me no more. So I'm going to get in the studio one day down there. And,
no, you're not.
You never know. But great show. And to that listener, I don't know what time he listens to, but I'm surprised I wasn't listed on his complaint.
Why well, everybody loves
Drew,
right?
Ross, did you get those pictures over Travis? I sent to that KXNO email.
Dude, I don't get a KXNO email. What are you talking about?
I got him.
This is the one that gets those.
I thought you had them to everybody on there. All right, I will disperse them. I'll take care of that.
No, but I sent you guys pictures from the wedding. Travis and Ross are there. It was a good time.
That's what you had tagged on it, so I just looked at it and said, they're pictures of Ray, Travis, and Ross.
Yeah,
I'm assuming they went to everybody.
And
I'll take care of it.
And I thought I was a good spectator. I wasn't rude to these
people. You were great, Ray.
I wasn't running down people from Colorado getting in their face like Tim was saying I was going to do.
No. Hey, you're the one who said you were going to do that. Can I ask you a question, though?
You know what I mean? But I was there to observe. I was more of there as a reporter, you know.
Well, I was going to ask you, because every time I've met you now, which was, I think, officially been three times, the first at the Drake Grandview tailgate was the first time I met you. Then I met you at the barbecue drive-thru out in front of the station. Then I met you at the wedding last week. But two of those three times, you had a video camera with you. What are you doing with that video camera?
Well, I make videos for my weekly videos that I've been doing. Powerball.
Okay, but you don't know
what
you and I are. Or tokers?
No, not at all.
Okay,
but you know the sad thing is the footage from the tailgate end up on the cutting room floor, like footage from the wedding on WHO TV, and no mention of TNT.
Oh,
yeah, okay. It was bad technical on my fault. I didn't have backed up, and I ended up deleting it. And I was pissed. I captured the last. I captured the last event. It was great.
All right,
and great show, guys. Keep going.
See you right
later.
Thanks, Ray. Right.
I was all pissed, then I hung out in the basement for a few minutes.
Took a couple hits, I wasn't pissed no more.
I love
Crusaders is your nickname of the
Crusaders.
Day.
Crusaders. What's the name of that college again?
William Carey University in Hattiesburg, Mississippi.
Smoking marijuana like a Woodstock hippie.
William.
But spelled the same.
I think actually one minus one E. Maybe
I can't believe Van took him off his email list. That's awesome.
Please delete me from your email list. Please don't send me anything else. If you want to send brownies, feel free to, but don't send me an email. I don't think Van's accepting the baked goods.
I don't know. It seems like any type of food shows up at this place. There's food in the break room.
No. That's because it all comes to WHO, because for some odd reason they give people the
break. Call him.
No, I understand.
284-5966. Tell them Brimstone Array in the studio.
Brownies. Everybody have a
good Chronic day. Minute.
Everybody is in the break. Crusaders, your nickname of the day. Go to the KX.
That's it. Powerbowl 14. Can't think of anything that correlated with 14 but my age when I was 14. That was the first time I smoked marijuana. When I was 14. I had to work a couple times. Smoked at the Bruce Springsteen concert. And my best friend is Mark Bell. I ended up smoking for a couple more months there. That's how ninth grade I started again that summer. I had a girlfriend. She's a doctor now. Back when we were in seventh grade, or was it early eighth grade or something like that? She was like trying to get Mark to get her some weed. You know, and she was in seventh, and I was like, I'm just like, I thought marijuana was so evil and bad and everything like that. You know, but I'd gotten drunk and puked and smoke cigarettes and everything like that, but I was just, you know, I was consumed with reefer madness growing up and going to a Catholic school. And so this girlfriend, my girlfriend Michelle, Shelly, well, I don't know what she thinks of me these days, but I know she's probably pretty happy I'm doing okay, but she's a doctor now. But she wanted Mark to get her spot, and I got all mad. And I was like, oh, don't do it. You know, it's like, you're going to waste your $10 and then send me $10 next week. And, you know, and my brothers, my older brothers, they'd already, you know, they were high school age and they'd smoked and everything like that. I was just consumed by the reefer madness until I tried it. And then I didn't even really want to drink beer ever again. And that's probably part of the reason why I rarely do these days. So, bringing it down. Powerbowl 14 tomorrow night. Hope you all enjoy this video. I'm gonna start doing these promo videos right here on Ustream.
Stand ground, shake your hand like the realest man around in your town, kicking you down for a minute, but everything in life have its limits, beginning only to end it, as if it was intended, the troops I have to take in the streets, I'm representing, for each one who step on the creek, a record image, you can sleep for each consecutive second, that's independent from each hour, I speak as if I was the only source of power, keeper of people's all with knowledge in my conscious tower, I read the fake like characters in fictitious novels, and yet between the lines I find more follow, a most hollow way of life to model. False dream vessel, stress in the bottle. Now you're better off pushing a lot. Kick me down is all I hear nowadays. Break me off, you can say it in a thousand ways. Give me this.